So you know what's super awesome, is shooting a whole video from start to finish and realizing that your primary camera was still set to shoot in slow motion. Yeah, so you get to do it all again. That's awesome. So hopefully I've set the camera back up properly so that it functions. Today we are looking at the Ordro Brave 1. This is a budget action camera. And many of you, or some of you may have heard of Ordro, and many have not. But for those that have watched my videos, you may have seen me use this in the past. This is the Ordro EP7, and it's a point of view camera that you kind of just slap on here and off you go. And I actually really like it. Is the quality as good as a GoPro or Insta360 or Osmo Action? Probably not to that level, but it's completely hands-free. I can do stuff with my hands. It's easy to put on. The quality is good enough for the times that I need it for. So I actually really, really like it. So I'm interested to see how this quality is, being that this is a newer camera in comparison to that, and see what it comes with, etc., etc., etc. And that's what we're gonna do today. We're going to look at this, see what comes in the box. We're going to take it out for a little walk, and then we'll let you know what we think of the Ordro Brave 1. Coming up. I felt really almost like rehearsed, and it's because it feels like I've done this video multiple times already. Anyways, here's their Amazon listing. So here's number one. I didn't see it on Amazon.com. They don't seem to have it, but on Amazon.ca, $216. Okay, weird number, $216.33. Okay, but it's got a long delivery. Like even ordering today, and this is mid May, somewhere in that range. I think it's like the 18th today. You guys are seeing this because I'm recording lots of videos. Could arrive as late as like the first week of July. So I was like, oh, well, that's not like a Prime thing. That's not coming through Prime. So what happens if we were to go to like Banggood? $142, that's better, $142. So save yourself like $60, $70, because it's still, they say shipping time 15 to 30 days. Same thing, you're gonna get it around June or July, sorry, right? So I'd order there, save the money, and you're good to go, because it's all coming from the same place. So let's go back to Amazon just so we can see the specs on this thing. So it does have anti-shake, very cool. It does have a 1/3 inch, it does have a Sony sensor. So it's a 13 megapixel sensor, and remember that, 13 megapixels, can shoot up to 4K 60. It says 20 megapixel photos, so be aware, it's a 13 megapixel sensor. So 20 megapixels photos means that it is up-resing, because you can't get 20 out of 13. That doesn't work. Built in special effects. It has like slow-mo and time-lapse and blah, blah, blah. And smart Wi-Fi connection. Now this is something to kind of be aware of as well. And I'm not 100%, but I think this is what it is. On the EP7, not a lot of buttons. Power button, photo button, video button. That's kind of it. So you have to use the Ordro app to kind of go in and make changes to that. Little extra step, but it makes it so that the camera can be the size that it is, and I appreciate that, but it does make it a little more inconvenient if you don't, for whatever reason, have like your smartphone with you. I have a feeling that this is going to be similar, that it's going to need the app, and that could be something that's a hindrance, or maybe you don't care. Once you set it and forget it. That's kind of for me, because usually my settings are the same no matter what. Once I get the settings alike, they're done, and you're good to go. So we'll take a look. We won't go into the app necessarily, but we'll see if we think that's a thing. All right, here's the box. Ordro Brave 1 4K anti-shake sports camera. Very cool. That's it right there. Some specs right there. Sony CMOS 13 megapixel. It is, it looks like an F2 lens on it. And can take, blah, 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 blah. I can't speak very good lately. Me not speak good. And it can take upwards of a 256 gig memory card. So that's kind of nice. More specs, but you guys can go to Ordro's website if you so choose to get some more specs on it. All right, let's crack it open. Crack it open, because I've never done this I've done it numerous times. Okay, so in the box, just so you guys can see, micro USB to USB-A. Would have liked to have seen USB-C, but it is what it is, right? You get this, which I don't really know what it is. I have a feeling it's so you can write down your own like personal information in regards to like when you bought this or warranty stuff. I don't know, it's all in Chinese, so I can't read it. This is has like your after sale at ordro.cn if you're looking at needing to get a hold of them. You get a manual. Now I do like the manual. It is fairly large, it goes through and tells you all the operations. Now my version came with a 32 gig SanDisk Extreme card. Now I don't know if that's always what they come with, but I got one. So I'm super happy. That's a nice little card. And I got this little card reader. Again, it seems a little out of place, right? This kind of weird purpley, which is fine, but you know, it doesn't say anywhere that you should be getting this, but I got it. It's got ability to all kinds of different kind of cards on there. So that's also really cool. All right, now here is the camera stuff. You get handlebar mount. You get your standard little GoPro slidey plate thing. You get these. Now, you know what? These come with all cameras. I never ever use them, but you get two of them. So you don't get a ton of little accessories and a battery. Now, just so you guys know, battery is a, what is this? A 1350 milliamp hour. So my guess is you're gonna get an hour-ish for recording time. Okay, and then here's the camera. Comes with an underwater. It actually says here, I think the case says, you know, yeah, there it is. Wear waterproof shell, yeah, for 30 meters deep waterproof. Yes, cool. It seems really snug, which is good. It's on there decently. Now the other thing to be kind of aware of, if I can get this out, it's like I said, it's in there, which is good. I guess it's not gonna be shaking about. A little hard to get it out of there though. There it comes. Okay, it does have a little bump where the lens is to where it raises up, but here's the thing. There's not a lot of buttons. You have a power button on the front. You have your record button on the top. You have your turn your Wi-Fi on. And you have your USB and where you put your micro SD card. So also no external charger. So if you do happen to get extra batteries for this, I don't even know where you would get. Maybe you can get an extra or external charger from Ordro, possibly. I don't know. But right now you're gonna have to charge through the actual camera. Does have a nice door for the battery, which I appreciate because some of the budget ones, the door just, they're not great. They need to invest a bit more in the doors. This door's nice. Still having problems with talking. Nice. Okay, so that slides in good. Very cool. And then of course over here, you get a nice little rubber water resistant for like splashing probably, seal, which is good. And you'll see on here that you do get your micro USB, you get probably a micro HDMI and an SD card. So we'll put our SD card in there right now. Yes, we will. And that's going in like so. I think, did I get that right? Nope. I'll get it right. There's only one or two ways to put it in. So I think there we go. And we're gonna turn it on. So we'll move all this off to the side because I don't need it right now. And front button, right? Front button. You guys hear the plane? There you go. Oh, it turns on fast. That was quick. Now, this of course is gonna record. That makes sense. Now, if we tap the power button, do we get anything? Where's the power button right there? Tap. So this allows you to go through, it seems. All right, so this is gonna go to your photo. Oh, you do get some stuff. Maybe you can, is it touchscreen? Nope, not touchscreen. So how do I go through them? Video playback, okay, no. Like, I don't know, maybe Wi-Fi? Oh yeah, so the Wi-Fi button now goes through. So if I want to go to video settings, so front button goes through them, video settings, I'm gonna hit this. That's like your okay button. And this I'm gonna hit again, video resolution. Oh, so you can do it all from here, very good. Let's go to 4K. Let's go to 4K, no 24s, but you guys can see it a whole bunch here. 720 up to 120, 4K 60, 4K 30. Yeah, all coming together. Let's do, but you can only go down. So if you miss something, just be aware. That's it, right? And then, do I hit this to enter? Do I hit this one? Maybe? I guess so. Exposure compensation? Nope. Which way am I going through these? This one again? I can't remember now. Yep. Loop video? Sure, if you want to. Time lapse video intervals, you can set that. Slow motion movie, fast motion movie, HDR, time step. HDR, let's figure that out, right? HDR? Let's go on, right? Let's do it up. Date stamp, go into that. Off, correct. And that's kind of it for your actual video. Come back out. All right, I think we're good. So now I'm gonna go back to video. All right, so let's actually, let's go take some shots. Let's go take some video. I'm gonna mount this on a GorillaPod and we're gonna hand hold it. So I wanna hand hold it because I want us to be able to hear what this little microphone is like. All right, stay tuned, we'll be right back. All right guys, so we are outside. And we're trying this out. You guys can see or hear what the audio is like right now. I'm talking just normal. It smells really nice out here. It's got, you guys see it? You got like the cool lilac bushes or trees or whatever. But we're gonna do a walk with some stabilizations. You can't seem to disable stabilization, so it's just kind of on. But I'm gonna spin this around. You guys will be able to see what this kind of does. Here, this is some nice shot. You guys can see how good it is, what it's like for quality. This is all gonna be untouched as well, right? All handheld. I was going to use a GorillaPod, but the biggest issue, of course, is there's no tripod mount or anything on this. You know, what would have made this thing fantastic is a tripod mount on the bottom of it, but that's not there. Oh, look at these, more flowers. Hold on. Okay, how pretty is that? And this audio again, all untouched. It doesn't look like you can change the width or anything. It just is what it is. But the screen looks good. Stability looks decent. And I've got this out at arm's reach, just kind of walking with it in my hands. Again, the only way to mount this onto like a GoPro or anything is with like the waterproof case on, and because of that, of course, your audio goes into complete garbage or noneness because it's got a waterproof case on it. So we're just gonna finish our little walk through here because it's cool like that, and it's a nice day finally. It's been so yuck out. Finally nice day, but I can't really tell where I'm doing this. And I can't get it out as far as I normally would, because normally I'd have it on like I said, a stick. But I can't really do that and talk. So yeah, let's go inside. I'm gonna take a look at this footage. You guys will be able to see at least the quality in at least nice lighting, you know. Here's a nice little tree shot. And yeah, I'm gonna go and take a look. And tomorrow, like I said, I think I might mount this on my helmet. We'll go for a quick motorcycle ride tomorrow. Yes? Yeah. A lot of bugs out today. A lot of bugs. All right, let's go upstairs. We'll take a look at the footage and take a listen to see what it sounds like. All right. All right, so we're back. We've had a chance to take a listen to the audio from this and take a look at the video from this. And first off, the positives. The build quality of it actually is surprising. It feels a lot more, I don't want to go to the point of saying it's premium, but a lot better than what you would come to expect from, I think, a budget action camera. So yeah, in that aspect, the build quality actually quite nice. Looking at the footage, I would say the stabilization, being that it was handheld, and as close as it was to me, is okay. It's okay. It's not fantastic. It's okay. I'm going to be a lot more curious to see how well it does on a motorcycle ride tomorrow when it's just kind of sitting here versus me just kind of walking around, because that has a lot to do with just how steady I am as well, right? So I think right now it's okay. You can. It's kind of funny. When you look actually at the actual lens, and you move the camera around, you can actually see it floating. So it is stabilizing. You can see the actual lens moving around. So that's kind of cool. But I'm curious to see what its limits are when it's shooting something actually quite wide, right? Like landscape. Color-wise and all that, image quality, actually not too bad. Actually, I was impressed. It doesn't seem to be like it's oversaturated or blown out or anything like that. I think it was doing a fairly good job, so that's all right. Audio quality was pretty decent. Now, of course, when the wind kicked in, the audio was not great. But, you know, if you were to be able to put something, because it looks like the microphone's right on the top. So if you were to put like a little, you can buy those little sticker, like almost like little muffs that you can get for cameras, a little sticker to put on there. I think that would actually help. But the quality of the audio out of this, surprised, actually not bad at all. I thought it was quite good, especially for a budget camera. Last but not least, I wish it had a tripod mount or came with a, like a naked case, something that you can just wrap around it so that it has a tripod mount, because the only real way to get it on a tripod or a gorillapod or anything is to use this. And I don't want to use this when I'm just walking around, because then I get like no audio, right? So it would have been nice to have some kind of housing that went on this that just gave it like a quarter inch on the bottom so that I could mount it that way, because as of now, not really an option. Because even this, right, I was like, oh, maybe I could figure out a way to get this attached to something, but I still need this case, so it just doesn't matter. So that's something to be aware of. Software wise I did play around a little bit with the software is the exact same software that I've used with the EP7. So nice and easy. You turn the Wi-Fi on here, you open up the app, it connects, and you can get a live preview. It can be useful, especially if you're framing, right? Especially something that I'll probably try to do tomorrow if I'm getting this on a helmet and I want to get it framed properly before I start riding. As well as it allows you to download footage and preview your footage and change some of your settings, et cetera, et cetera. Not a lot of settings in there though. Now, I thought you'd be able to go in and change like maybe the width or change if you wanted the stabilizer on or off, but nope, it is what it is. So it's a certain 120 degrees. You do get the opportunity to go in and change like your resolutions and frame rates and things like that. But those are things you can do straight with the camera as well. So for now, I think at the $140 point, not bad. And that's Canadian, right? That's not bad. It's a decent little camera. If you want to spend $100 more, you start getting into like the premium cameras, right? Like the Osmo Action right now is $250. So, and that's $250 US. So maybe I'm a little wrong, because it's about $300 Canadian. So this is still about half the price of an Osmo. You really have to watch, right? They're getting closer together, but you can get two of these. Yes, you can get two of these. The only thing to realize, like I said, is that it's not going to be fantastic if you're going to get this and be able to possibly want to use it like for like a vlogging, because its focus, I found, wasn't like, if you're holding the camera here, you're a little soft. The focus is a bit behind you because it's a fixed focus distance. So because of that, it doesn't like autofocus and try to hit you. It's got a focus distance a little further than my arms reach. So if you have shorter arms than me, then you're kind of in trouble. Shooting this way, again, tomorrow, I think when we take it out on the motorcycle, it'll be a better test for it. So make sure you guys come back tomorrow to see that. I'm gonna leave you there. If you have any questions or if you've used this Ordro camera, leave your comments down below. And that's all. I'll put links to Banggood's website if you are interested in going to take a look at this. And we'll see you fine folks tomorrow. Like, comment, share, subscribe, hit the bell. And yeah, motorcycle ride tomorrow. It's going to happen. All right, my friends. See you then. Later.